Hey, brothers and sisters, I want to make a quick second video. God bless you guys. Glory to God in the highest. Peace on earth. Goodwill toward all men is what the angels proclaimed at the birth of Christ. The Word of God says how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It's like the oil that ran down from the beard of Aaron, even unto his garments and to the hem of his garments. Brothers and sisters, Psalm 133, Psalm 127, except the Lord build the house, those that labor in vain, those who labor in vain. You know, they're wasting their time getting up early, as it says in the next verse. Brothers and sisters, the Lord has commissioned me to get on here and do a call for unity among the brethren, unity among the watchmen. I call on Minister Paul Begley. I know he's busy making lots of videos and doing his radio show. I call on Minister Paul Begley, Pastor Paul Begley. I call upon Minister Paul. I call on all of those watchmen on the wall who are born-again Christians, not to ecumenicalism, to unite with all this Jehovah's Witnesses and Mormons and whatnot, but for all born-again Christians, followers of Christ, to unite for revival, for prayer and fasting and unity. And I would just put this out. I know some of you guys who watch my videos, you also watch Pastor Paul Begley, that you know that I would go there and meet with him as the Lord has directed me. And I believe that we should take, as the Lord has directed me, that we should take anointing oil. A gallon or 10 gallons of anointing oil and pray over it. Lay hands on it. If the watchmen, anointed servants of God would come together and pray over that anointing oil. Even as it says in Psalm 133, you know, the representing the Holy Spirit, that the oil ran down Aaron's beard, the high priest representing Jesus. Jesus is the head of the church, the high priest of the church, Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us that that oil, the anointing, the Holy Spirit would run down his beard, even to the hem of the garments, to the whole body. For revival, brothers and sisters, the last revival to bring in the last sheep, the last harvest before the tribulation begins, brothers and sisters, to get all the bride saved and sanctified and walking with the Lord. Born again. It's truly born again. Repented and walking with the Lord. So therefore, brothers and sisters, those of you who are watching this, I ask you, if you're in contact with Pastor Paul Begley, because he's the biggest one on YouTube, you know, that contact him. Let's get together and as brothers and sisters in the Lord, let's lay hands on that oil to the men of God who are watchmen on the wall. Let's anoint that oil, and then we can send it out. Let's send it out. Ask people just to help us pay for the, you know, the containers and the shipping, and ship out the oil in little vials to all the brothers and sisters who would have one. We come in, let that oil represent us coming together in unity and agreement, like they did on the day of Pentecost. Let's come in agreement, like the 120 did in the upper room. Seek the Lord and seeking, you know, a new Pentecost, a new outpouring of the Holy Spirit, a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon His people. Brothers and sisters, this is a commission from the Lord to do this. And I know the Lord will make a way for this message to get to who it needs to get to. Brothers and sisters, that we would see a revival of the real children of God, brothers and sisters, before it's everlasting too late, that we can finish the harvest, bring in those last sheep. God bless you guys. I look forward to hearing from the other watchmen who will come in agreement and unity, overcome any differences you have with each other. Silly nonsense that the Lord is going to be angry with us about on Judgment Day when we've been, you know, if we've been disagreeing over nonsense, non-essential doctrines. Even as the Moravians' motto, in essentials unity, non-essentials diversity, but in all things love. Let's have unity. I call for it right now in the name of Jesus Christ and the authority as a servant of Jesus Christ. I call for unity among the brethren that we can reach the highest levels on the mountain of God. I believe that's also unity among the brethren is from Galatians chapter 3. It's in Galatians. God bless you guys.